National Institute of Ocean Technology, NIOT, strives to fulfill the nation's needs by developing ocean technology for fresh water, food, ocean state forecast, and technical consultancy service and transfer of technology. Islands of Union Territory Lakshadweep are experiencing the acute shortage of drinking water during non-monsoon due to increase in population associated with limited area to store rainwater. ESSO NIOT has established 3 desalination plants in islands of Lakshadweep at Kavrati 2005, Minicoy and Agatti 2011 using low temperature thermal desalination LTTD technology. These plants are being maintained by the administration with locally trained manpower for the past 4 years at Minicoy and Agatti and 10 years at Kavrati. LTTD technology is environmentally friendly and less maintenance intensive compared to most commonly used reverse osmosis technique. A proposal to establish similar plants in 6 more islands of Union Territory Lakshadweep at Androth, Amini, Chetlat, Kadmath, Kalpeni and Kiltan Islands is under active consideration. The islands are generally made of coral with a lagoon on the western side and proximity of deep water on eastern side. The plant is located on the eastern side of the island to minimize the length of cold water pipe. The cold water at 12 degrees Celsius is drawn from a depth of 380 meter located at a distance of 1000 meter from coast. The plant at Agatti is located at a distance of 100 meter from the coast in intertidal zone to optimize the pumping losses, and intake structure is located at a distance of about 230 meter from the shore in a water depth of 5 meter. Island-based desalination plant consists of marine structures, submarine pipe and process equipment. The major challenges for establishing the desalination plants in remote islands are design and construction of marine structure such as sump, bridge under extreme wave and current conditions. Design and installation of deep sea cold water pipe under varied ocean currents. Erection of plant equipment without any heavy lifting or moving equipment. The deep sea cold water at 12 degrees Celsius and warm water at 28 degrees Celsius are drawn into 2 separate chambers in the intake structure separated by a wall. About 180 kg per second of warm water at 3 meter head and 150 kg per second of cold water at 5 meter head is pumped into the plant building through submersible pumps using HDPE pipes supported on the bridge. Warm water is evaporated in the flash chamber, which is maintained at 27 millibar using a 2-stage vacuum system with a suction capacity of 36 kg per hour. The evaporated water is condensed in a shell and tube condenser with about 1120 cupro-nickel tubes fed by the deep sea cold water to generate the potable fresh water. About 1% of fresh water is processed from salt water, which is drawn at 180 kg per second, and the remaining water is discharged into the sea without any increase in the salt concentration. The flash chamber, condenser, vacuum system, power cum motor control panel, etc. are transferred through the bridge from the coast using simple transporting equipment. All these components are erected without any major lifting equipment. Cold water at 12 degrees Celsius is drawn into the intake structure using a 630 mm diameter HDPE pipe by the submersible pump located in intake structure. The 1000 meter long HDPE pipe used for cold water is fabricated by fusion welding of 12-meter pipe sections in the lagoon on western side of island. Connections such as friction grip hold fasts, radial pin assemblies, etc. are attached at the ends to transfer the axial load to the steel pipe and then to the intake structure. Assembled pipe is torn into the lagoon using crane barge by attaching suitable buoyancy chambers to the HDPE pipe. After positioning the pipe at site as per the alignment, the front end of the pipe is secured at about 5-meter water depth through shore connections, and the rear end of the pipe attached with about 10-ton clump weight is gradually released from the barge to reach 400-meter water depth. Then, the front end connections to the sump with flexible hoses, shock cells and steel pipes are completed as required. The cold water pipe forms an inverse catenary pattern of 30-meter water depth to about 400-meter water depth. Concrete blocks are placed at regular intervals up to 30-meter water depth for safely carrying the water from 400-meter depth to the sump. Major components of marine structure are 1. Seawater intake caisson, 2. Bridge, and 3. Plant building. The design and construction of marine structure in islands is complex due to the prevailing ocean waves and non-availability of heavy lifting or moving equipment. All the construction materials need to be transported from the mainland to the islands. An innovative construction methodology that is suitable for these islands has been evolved. Seawater intake caisson, weighing up to 400 tons, is partly constructed in the western side of the island on the shore to the required height and weight, and then launched into the lagoon water with the help of a jack and roller mechanism. The caisson wall is further built in different stages in the lagoon to the required height to obtain a draft of about 1.8 meters. The caisson is stowed about 10 kilometers through the shallow lagoon channel with a mean water depth of 2.8 meters and then in the open ocean using a tugboat with a 10-ton bollard pull capacity. The caisson is designed for floating stability for its safe towing in the lagoon and in open ocean, since the entire operation may take up to 7 hours. The intake caisson is further raised up to the required height, then ballasted and lowered in the final location using 4 anchors placed on the seabed by allowing the seawater into the caisson, and then the caisson walls are raised to reach the final level. The total bridge of length 230 meters is constructed in 3 different stretches with varied construction methodology for 3 distinct zones. Namely, 1. Intertidal zone of 130 meters, 2. Wave breaking zone of 60 meters, and 3. Beyond wave breaking zone of 40 meter length. In intertidal region, footing and pier with 1 meter height, weighing about 1.5 tons, is cast at about 1.5 meter above the seabed level on the scaffolding platform. Footing is lowered to the seabed using an A-frame and pulley. Floating technique is used for construction of piers in the 3 to 5 meter water depths, where footings are cast in the lagoon using structural steel pontoons attached to footing. The piers with its footing is floated and towed from lagoon to plant location and lowered by ballasting in 3 to 5 meter water depth to required bridge alignment. All these operations involve assessment of tide and wave conditions. The pier and footing in wave breaking area is cast in elevated platform made of structural steel sections instead of ordinary scaffolding pipes and lowered using higher capacity chain pulley blocks due to the higher wave loads. Bridge deck up to wave breaking area for a length of 140 meters is cast by in-situ concrete supported by ordinary scaffolding pipes in intertidal area. Plate girder bridge is adopted for a length of 60 meters beyond wave breaking area. Structural steel plate girder is fabricated in mainland in 20 meter sections and brought to site. Plate girder bridge is assembled on complete bridge in intertidal zone and launched using rollers and electric capstan till last pier on the intake caisson. The plate girder is supported by intermediate A-frame to avoid misalignment during launching and to hold the plate girder in position. Steel surface of the plate girder is covered with micro-concreting to avoid corrosion due to marine environment. The deck slab of plate girder is covered with precast and cast-in slabs. In the wave breaking zone, structural steel supports are used to withstand the high wave action for a span of 30 meters. The planned building footings in the intertidal zone are also cast using staging, concreting and lowering technique. Entire plant building in intertidal area was constructed in 3 months' time. Desalination plant with 1 lakh liters capacity at Minicoy and Agatti were completed in 2011. These plants are maintained by the Public Works Department of Union Territory Administration using the local manpower for the past 4 years to serve drinking water needs of local population.